Hello, I'm just shooting a .22 air rifle. So the pellets, the metal pellets, come in packs of 500. Just lock it like so. It has a scope on it too. So safety's on, off. So a metal pellet is less lethal than a bullet, and so it's very safe for just kind of for shooting by yourself in a farm. An option for shooting with rifles is to collect the rifles from a gun club and to shoot it then back at your property with family members. So that way there'd be some degree of security with other people around. But with an air rifle, it's safe enough to society because it's less lethal. So it can be very relaxing in the countryside, and so I understand why a lot of people would enjoy just shooting by themselves at their own farms. Instead of shooting at a kind of an indoor gun club, but obviously you can make it kind of as recreational as you want as kind of an outdoor gun club, and you could also collect the rifles, as I was saying, from the gun club for outdoor hunting with others. Thank you. I'll fire another one at the target. So my aim with the air rifle has improved since my training with the guns, the handguns and the rifles at the gun club back in Turkey. Bullseye.
So I'm not sure. Let's partially see the crosshairs and the target. So, confirmation.
Hello, so convention says to pull the trigger with your dominant hand, but I find resting the air rifle a bit heavy on my weaker hand. So I'll try something different, and I'm going to hold the rifle with my stronger arm and pull the trigger with my weaker arm. So my eyesight is of equal strength on both eyes, so it doesn't really matter aiming with which eye I use. So I've got this idea after thinking about the Jew wielding the pistols at the back in Turkey. So something similar. My left shoulder is where the butt of the air rifle is going into. I enjoyed hitting that. I'm not entirely sure where it went in the target. I have too many holes in it already, so I'll try one more time. So the safety is on, and I'll turn it off. Very well. So that's another option if your arms are tired, just to swap the arm positions. Both have kind of an important role. Both arms have an important role for holding the rifle, so you don't gain too much more by using your dominant hand to pull the trigger. Because steadying the rifle, particularly if you're aiming for a long time, can be just as important. Thank you. I'm just going to try kneeling, and I'll use my weaker arm to pull the trigger, my strong arm to hold the air rifle. So, if you're confused with the sights on the weaker arm, you can kind of look through the sights kind of diagonally to pull the sights closer towards you. Thank you. Hello, so I'm going to kneel, and I'm going to use my strong arm to hold the rifle again, my weaker arm to pull the trigger. Thank you.
An air gun's ammunition can be very efficient for combat and self-defense, because when you think about it, you've got 500 of these in a little packet would fit in your pocket, whereas just imagine having 500 rounds of bullets, it was almost cripple your back. So you could carry around these all day long, and you'd have up to 500 shots available to you. So that's one mighty advantage of an air rifle compared to a bullet rifle.
Another advantage of air rifles is for night combat, because they're very kind of stealthy, very kind of quiet. They don't have a loud kind of bang when you shoot them, and they're also very lightweight, which would be very important for kind of moving stealthily or for long distance trekking, because there's no point having a very good kind of shot in your technique, but only to be exhausted by the time you have an opportunity to hit something. So that's yet another advantage of an air rifle. Thank you. Hello, I want to hit a target while I'm strolling, so my legs will be moving while I hit it. So I'll kind of sidestep slowly sideways. So I'm very close to the target because the motion makes it a small bit more difficult. So as you can see, it was just moving very slightly. Now I'll kind of move forward very slightly. Now backwards. Thank you. Hello, so I'm going to lie prone. and depending on the cover position, I might try and lie supine. Hello, and finally I'm going to do a sit-up position. Thank you. He went straight through, but both sides there. That's the exit, and then that's the entry. So you can see how big of a hole it made in the entry.